is through. Love and I have made a happy start again. The leaves lie on the ground, the world just turned around. It isn't fall at all, you see, it's spring that I have found. There's frost in Central Park, at five it's almost dawn. What's the difference when you've had your sweet amount? There's snowflakes in the sky, and geese are flying high, but there's April in my heart again. Woo! I want to start off by saying how much of a privilege it is to be here on this stage today. I've been coming to see this festival for a few years now, but I finally got the opportunity to do tribute to my musical idol, Billie Holiday, with this fantastic band, and it's going to be great fun. I'm really looking forward to it. That first song was called April in My Heart. It was recorded in 1938. All of these are sort of around that time period, with the Teddy Wilson Orchestra. Featured Matthias Seuffert, it featured McQuaid at the beginning, and a bit of Rico, and of course, Dave Boeddinghaus doing Teddy Wilson. You'll hear a lot of that because I love Teddy Wilson, and all of these, like the piano solo tunes, including the next one, which is called Hello My Darling, and it was from the same year, but a later recording session, still with Teddy Wilson, so we'll do that one now. Your tender kiss, I'll be brave after this. I'll say hello, my darling, if we should meet again. You'll forgive the tears too soon. You'll behave, bite your lip, and say hello, my darling, if we should meet. Thank you.
So when I was asked to do a set at Whitley Bay this year, they said like, oh, why don't you do the Billie Holiday, because I do a lot of the Billie Holiday stuff. And I thought like, I could do like the small band recordings from the sort of mid-30s that everyone knows. But then I thought like, this festival you get the opportunity to kind of like do whatever you want and ask for whatever you want, you get it. So I said like, can I have a 10-piece band? Four saxes. And they were like, yeah, come on. So not only have I got a 10-piece band, I've got like the most amazing musicians to play this sort of music in my little 10-piece band. And I love these recordings because they've got these four-part sax harmonies under all the vocals, which I hope you're all listening out to because they are delicious. Yeah. So the next one is going to be a bit of a fun one. And it's going to feature, it features an opening chorus by Bobby Hackett on the cornet, which Father over there will do. Yeah, this is called You're Gonna See a Lot of Me. It's a really fun one. Transitional point in Billie Holiday's career. This is the little history lesson segment because I've done a little bit of homework for this. So, because there are these sort of like larger bands compared to the smaller bands of the early 30s, and also because it's sort of marked between like her leaving the Artie Shaw Orchestra earlier in 1938 and a couple of years before she sort of signs with Decca, which is the next big move of her establishing herself as a proper solo artist, rather than sort of like just the female singer with bands. And I think the fact that these came just a few months after she left Artie Shaw, and that was quite a traumatic experience for those of you who know the history of her being sort of like this black singer in this all-white touring band and a lot of the troubles that she came across doing that. And also like a female singer in an all-male band, that can be a lot sometimes. But there's definitely more intersection to look at there. So I like these pieces because they kind of like sit in the middle, and I think they reflect a bit of the change to come and where she's sort of headed. So this next one is the last one from 1938 with the Teddy Wilson Orchestra, and it's a really sweet little one. It's called You're So Desirable. Just can't resist you. You're so desirable. I had to give in. That firm resolve I made has vanished away now. I'm happy to say moment I saw you, it's just deplorable, the fool that I've been, and yet I'm glad you have my heart, dear, like a butterfly on a pin. You're so desirable, I had to been sort of like the same tempo, but there's a reason for that, and it's my favourite tempo. Like, all of these songs, just like the feel of them in this like mid-tempo are great. Like, my dad was having a go at me earlier for saying like, oh, you've done all these mid ones, and I was like, it's because they sound really cool. But we're gonna make it up for you now by doing a really slow one and then a really fast one to end the set. So this one is a ballad. It was recorded 2 years later in 1940 under Billie Holiday's own name, which is like the next step. This is one of my favourite Billie Holiday songs of all time. And the first time I heard it, the trumpet solo made me cry. And it's Roy Eldridge on this record. So I know he's had a bit of a Roy Eldridge warm-up earlier, but that's what we've got to do. It's got to make me cry on stage. Well, hopefully not actually, because I've got to sing it, but this is called I'm All For You. Say what they want to say. If I'm wrong, I'll be the one to pay. No matter if they do, you'll find that I'm all for you. Let the cards redeemed, we'll drift apart, and the sky foretell a broken heart. No matter if they do, you'll find that I'm all for you. we do our last number, I will introduce the band. On the altos, we have Mike McQuaid. Lorenzo Baldasso. On the tenors, Matthias Seuffert. On trumpet and cornet, Enrico Tomasso. On trombone, Alistair Allan. Josh Duffee. On bass, Henri Lemaire. Guitar, Félix Hunot. And on the piano, my Teddy Wilson for this half an hour, Dave Boeddinghaus. This last one is the other side of that record.
I just want to interrupt. I'm going to interrupt everyone because you know that she is singing, obviously, wonderfully, and introducing the set as well. But I just wanted to let you know that all these arrangements are done by Gia as well. I'm not saying that to be patronizing because, you know, I know that these are, you know, wonderful professional quality arrangements, but particularly writing for four saxophones, which is a really challenging thing to do. I think that deserves a special round.
So, the last song, it's the other side of the record to I'm All For You, and it's a nice up-tempo one called I Hear Music.
Sure, that's music. Might survive.